when patients are told they have a brain tumor, obviously they're very anxious. And meningiomas are generally benign tumors. It tends to be not terribly invasive, and it's outside, resting on the outside of the brain rather than in deep within the brain. If we talk about meningiomas in the spine, they may have some neurological problems such as pain, weakness, numbness, neurological dysfunction, bladder or bowel disturbance. If we're talking about in the brain, it can produce symptoms from the areas pressing on the brain, may cause weakness and numbness, hearing difficulty, speech problems, visual impairment, can cause some headaches, nausea and vomiting. So it can cause a vast array of symptoms and signs depending on exactly where it is in the brain. Listening to a patient is one of the most important things you can do. I have my patients come in, they sit down, and I ask them what brings them here today, and I just let them talk. I'm fairly conservative, and you know, I consider surgery as a last resort. I like patients to have the full gamut of procedures and therapies before surgical intervention is considered. So it's not just you see me and let's operate straight away. It's, you know, we think about your problem, we work through the issues, we try alternatives, and then if it fails, then we have a discussion about surgical intervention. It's not just them, it's their family, it's their workmates, it's their children, and you've touched upon their life and you've made someone's life so much better.